Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we're going to be talking about the Ford Raptor's clever ability to switch between two-wheel drive, all-wheel drive, and four-wheel drive. Now you may be wondering, what is the difference between all-wheel drive and four-wheel drive? And generally what this means is all-wheel drive vehicles, the front drive shaft and the rear drive shaft will be able to operate at different speeds versus four-wheel drive, which is a selectable mode, locks these two axles, meaning that the front drive shaft and the rear drive shaft are both going to be rotating at the same speed. Now, all-wheel drive vehicles, because they allow for a speed differential, can drive on pavement versus four-wheel drive vehicles shouldn't drive on pavement if both of these drive shafts are locked and rotating at the same speed, because as you go around tight corners, it will cause binding within the system. So as far as the Ford Raptor, the first thing we're going to do is look at a general overview of the four-wheel drive system, then kind of deep dive into the transfer case and talk about the different driving modes which exist. So starting with the overview, you've got your engine. This is of course not to scale. You're not going to have this massive one drive shaft on one side and then a super tiny half shaft on the other. Not to scale, but point is you can kind of get what's going on. You've got your engine sending power to a transmission. That's sending power to the transfer case. That splits power between the front and the rear. They actually do have an optional Torsen front differential, limited slip diff, and then a locking rear axle. So a really good all-wheel drive system. And then you do have disconnecting hubs up front for operating in that two-wheel drive mode. So now let's look inside this transfer case at what's going on. First, we'll kind of look at the different components and then talk about how it works in the different drive modes. So you've got your engine power coming from the transmission in here. That's sending that through a reduction gear. So whether you're in four high or four low, which is switched using this range selector right here, power continues along this shaft to the four-wheel drive selector, so that will put you in four high or four low. That just basically combines these two shafts so that they now rotate at the same speed. This chain is connected to both this shaft and this shaft, so if you lock them together, both of these will rotate together. Then you have a wet multi-plate clutch, which is connecting between this shaft right here and this chain right here. That is your drivetrain, so able to drive the front drive shaft. Then in the middle here, you've got this selector shaft, which kind of has this, you know, slanted profile to it. So it's basically a cylinder. You have an electric motor that will rotate that cylinder. And as that cylinder rotates, it will force these selector forks into certain positions, allowing for you to choose between four high, four low, or neutral if you are towing the vehicle, and then selecting into four-wheel drive or disconnecting from that four-wheel drive. And there's, of course, return springs that force these back into position depending on how this rotates. So our first scenario, driving in too high, just driving those two rear wheels, you're going to have the front hubs disconnected. So you're going to be sending power just basically straight across to the rear wheels. This clutch pack will be spinning, but it's not locked up, so you don't have this spinning all that much. It will still receive some torque because you do have that wet multi-plate clutch in there, so you've got, you know, that viscous fluid, that oil in there. So as it rotates, it will transfer some torque, but again, you're not connected to those front wheels. Those half shafts may be rotating, as you can see in this little clip right here, but the wheels are actually disconnected from those half shafts, so they're not receiving any torque from the engine, even if those half shafts are rotating. That's just a result of, you know, the friction within this clutch pack, just from that viscous fluid floating around in there. Not locked up, again, once it's in that two-wheel drive mode, it's completely, you know, disconnected as much as it can be, so very little torque is actually passing through it, and all of that torque is going to your two rear wheels. Now, once you put it into four auto, what it's going to do is connect those front hubs. So now your wheels can be driven on the front, and it's going to start to lock up this clutch pack when needed. So in scenarios, you know, where you have slip or where you're not basically in a steady state, it's going to apply pressure to this clutch pack so that now you're connecting this drive shaft and this drive shaft through this clutch pack, through this chain. And so, you know, the more pressure you apply, obviously, the more lockup you get. But because it's all going through this clutch pack and not, you know, a locked chain, it does allow for slip. So the advantage of this is that you can use this on road. You can drive in the wet, in the snow, things like that on pavement, and you won't have binding of your axles because you do allow for slip within that clutch pack. And in steady state scenarios, let's say you're just cruising along the highway at 65 miles an hour, it can disconnect that, so you're really only just sending most power to those rear wheels and, you know, saving a little bit of energy. You don't need to send it to all four wheels in scenarios like that. So in steady state, it can disconnect. When you need it, it can lock up and act as an all-wheel drive system, you know, traditional all-wheel drive system out there, and allow you to drive on the road and still power all four wheels. So a very cool mode. Now, if you go off-road, you're gonna, of course, wanna put it into four-wheel drive. And so this means, you know, you'll let the slip occur at your wheels rather than within the drivetrain. And that's why you should only do it off-road, because otherwise you'll bind up this system and you can cause damage. So when you select four-wheel drive, you know, this will rotate, this electric motor will force this selector to push that fork in and connect this shaft with the front drive shaft via this chain. So it'll force that collar in. That will be connected, and now you're locking these two speeds. So always these two are going to rotate at the same speed, send that power to the front and rear differentials. And then, you know, if you want four low, of course, you select that with this range selector here, and that's just a gearing difference. So more aggressive gearing allows you to crawl, allows you to put more torque down. Now on the steering wheel, there's actually a drive mode selector, and this will choose the optimal setting for the four-wheel drive or all-wheel drive system for you. So you've got normal and sport, which will basically just leave it in two-wheel drive mode. You've got weather, which will put it in four auto. So, you know, if it's raining, things like that, if it's snowing, it will, you know, choose to send more power to the front axle when it needs it. You've got mud and sand, which will put it in four-wheel drive. Baja, and then rock crawl, which will put it in four low, so you can crawl and not have any slip and have a good amount of torque when you are driving up in super slow speed scenarios and get that benefit of the gear reduction. So a very cool four-wheel drive setup that Ford has incorporated within this truck, not to mention the fact that it has 450 horsepower, 510 pound-feet. So a very fun truck to drive, very cool all-wheel drive, four-wheel drive combination system. Thank you guys for watching. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below.